Hey, it's Sam. We asked you to tell us what you want to know about in the kitchen, and the topic of knives came up a bunch of times. So today we've got a little knife 101 for you, starting with types of knives.
The chef's knife. This is the most versatile and commonly used knife in a kitchen. It cuts, it chops, and the curved edge lets you rock the knife back and forth on a cutting board. Santoku is essentially just an Asian chef's knife that's actually lighter and a little thinner. Slicing knife. Think of this as a carving knife. It has a long, narrow design for slicing thinner slices of meat like roasts and ham. Fillet knife. Has a thin, flexible blade that's used mostly to fillet and prep fish. The serrated or bread knife. This is able to cut bread without crushing it and is perfect for cutting squishy things like soft tomatoes. And finally, the paring knife. The baby of the knife family is best for peeling things or for small close-up work like removing seeds from a jalapeno.
Okay, two more things you should know. A good knife will be made of high-quality stainless steel and it will have a full tang. That means that the steel in the blade will extend all the way as one piece through to the bottom of the handle. Knives are like cowboy boots in that they fit people differently. Just because I like an 8-inch chef's knife doesn't mean that you will. The best advice I can give you is hold the knife before you buy it. Make sure it's not too heavy or awkward in your hand. The knife you use most is the one that fits best in your hand. Okay, that's it. Of course, we could also tackle knife storage and sharpening, but we'll leave that for another time. See ya.